Sancho go can't retreat from the situation, and they still commit to the kill, and then proceed to actually be dead. And so I'm wondering what kind of what went on there. Is that a small, you know, lapse of judgment, or is this very much, you know, what makes it different from Kansas?
It's a really, you have to siege to win the game, right? But it's so scary to try to siege versus that small stuff like that. And it's not like a, well, if we siege the Augustus, then we'll stick together and we'll be alright, because then they're gusted into a perfect place to be split apart by Horrified. So it really was brilliant, those two together, Fnatic, and how they executed, and especially to see that kind of team with two players executing that synergy, who are just new teammates together.
Legitimately, very, you know, very first series, or game even to be able to play together. Practice and many who were at the forefront of the synergy. Obviously, everybody was a part of it. Tracer banned out behind the Fnatic. KZ's going to go ahead and ban the ETC in the first pick. Rego, no surprise that we see the Rego as the first pick.
Also, no surprise to see that KSV, after losing one game to Breeze's ETC, went back to the ETC ban. What is next now for KSV on Tomb? In the past, they have liked that Tracer play, so nice ban there. Essentially, we see Ragnaros here. It's crazy to see him jumping back up to the meta grid.
It is a little bit weird, you know, to kind of see what's going on. But at the same time, when we look at Ragnaros at first glance, when you hear kind of the notes of what are the core elements of his kit, there were things that stood out specifically towards maps on Tomb. No matter how many nerfs happen to his Q and to his 13 talent here and individual survivability, as long as you can, you know, cripple your opponents on a very questionable, you know, very difficult matchup to win that team, it really doesn't matter what else you do. It's kind of like somebody, you know, when your passive is so good at one element, so if the rest of your comp is just not terrible and that deters your opponent, their strengths enough, nothing else really matters.
I guess we still have some wave clear. Our Greymane. Resets Greymane back. Likely to be resets. It could be riches depending on the comp that they draft. Fnatic have beat Rhaegar. Without ETC here, where does Muradin fall? Or a noob, considering Fnatic.
Yeah, and you know, I feel like a new bracket is going to be a lot more popular in this tournament because of the adjustments into the burn, and I just don't know whether or not it's worth it in any to the bridge here, or whether or not it's worth placing the burn to the cloud being adjusted, especially because I don't think like 200 out of 5 block is not, but I was going to say, I think it's like the awareness as well. There are a lot of melees that do provide the things necessary on the map, like to the burden just, you know, just as a bunch of like the scoreboard set up for the rest of the squad.
Johanna, though. A lot of wave clear between Johanna and Rhaegar. Fnatic gets a Junkrat. Yeah, and Junkrat.
I mean, Fnatic could legitimately draft whatever heroes they possibly wanted in the last two picks. And as long as Rhaegar, Junkrat, and Johanna all go into their individual lanes, they are going to be a problem in this game. But that's how good their wave clear is. All of them are legitimately best within their class. That's going to be a problem for KSV. Unless they can find a way to bring the fight effectively, or the only other answer is to concentrate into 3-2. So that might be what you're talking about, because we are on 2.
KSV is trying to stifle the wave clear of Fnatic as much as they can now. Why they are going to ban the Orc? It is a very common type of job for Fnatic, even though we're seeing Junkrat be picked here, but they've, I think for a lot of part 2, maybe even phase 2, been highly focused on having a lot of wave clear for 2, which makes sense, right? You want to have that. Usually it's hard to get earlier on. Get yourself in a setup that you can just or be able to clear out so that if you're going to the top, it's just not nearly as detrimental to
you. And, you know, like, this is so weird and exciting if you, you know, want to think about it from a different angle because the map objective is connected to the minions, and it's really only a bad function if you think you're legitimately, you know,
job of the tournament, though. What do you think of that? Strong disengage? Maybe you're going to flailing swipe away the grip tire?
Yeah, and actually, I'm trying to think about what is the major selling point of a Stuka in this type of situation. You might be able to argue a decent ish way to play on top of it all, but I'm for the team right now, I don't struggle to be able to find it. I mean, there is a bit of synergy, like having the hard crowd control the slow crowd hard this, that we're likely to be struggling to settle into a longer duration. But a lot of the people on the side of the deck with the big boat, they have in the range and safety, which is not the goal, so the crowd is going to be that big of a problem. And we'll be able to eat here, though, with this deficit. Support tri-lane, you know, by having the hyper carry on a map like 2, Stukov silence is enough to make sure that you may be able to actually build that. I feel like that is the case considering the commitment to the Chrome Lane.
Playing Greymane, Kyotra on Stukov, and Sake playing Tastar.
Battle begins in 10 seconds.
Soon. Here we are. In the red. It is going to be Fnatic. We have Quack that's still on to the ball. Breeze is going to be Demona. Bang is going to be on Junkrat. Hardly played by Spence. We got Bad Benny there on Rengar.
Apologies if you just heard my water bottle, but I needed a drink to get pumped for this one. So let's go. Mene playing Junkrat. Huh. Is that the new mage? Is Junkrat a mage?
I think that's fair to definitely say that. A majority of his defense is his skills are high impact plays and what makes Junkrat a problem is based on his skills. it's not like, I don't feel like it's always where the damage comes from. It's more of like the element of the game is the way when people are doing it up spells versus auto attacks. That's the major deciding factor. Just generally just kind of correlate together.
Fala R at the bottom, so 1-2-2 from Fnatic. You see the change there. Great wave clear though for every single lane for Fnatic. KSB has Chromie and come together at the bottom.
Wow.
And that's what I was saying that they needed to do. Just get the blow up before a support for Fnatic giving them a chance to blink to throw up. Go get another.
For anybody at home, if you want to practice your own body block, I would strongly suggest doing it with Arthas and not with Arthas. I mean, you give a huge advantage to the matchup, and you know, it's pretty much training with for your own body block. It was nuts. But it was just very clean there from the CC. I hope you see that. The lurking arm as well. I feel like that would be about the most terrifying thing. Whatsoever, just because I have watched an insane amount of Stukov behind the scenes here so far in the tournament, there's been about, I feel like, every iteration of the game being used. And at this point, I feel like anything is viable, and I feel like a lot of the argument is that a lot of, you know, just the modes are viable. It's just, I want to see what you see. It's really going to be too
exciting. Andrade, I don't have any word to describe what just happened for Fnatic. I'm going to out. This damage is insane. Already struggling with the silences, trying to get back. That was a Johanna who used Iron Skin and still went down there. And this is like 3 minutes into this game. It probably only gets stronger as she keeps hitting these things.
Yeah, the Arthas is doing a great job being the second up behind as well. This has been a really cool early parts of this game, you know, for what immediately I was looking at. Should have a pretty well rounded safe composition. Very well, Lurk around the control of the sun, so my confidence in team is right, he's going to push back and Rich and keep that Fnatic alive. Rich, though, somehow keeps himself up there with Kyocha, and Fnatic loses him.
I love the concussion line that threw Rich not only off of the points, so then he can try to get it, but also just his teammates who tried to get that cut. But being able to, again, sniff out that Fnatic were at that camp, that they were going to need more people, and KSB making not only steal the camp away, so they didn't steal the camp, they did have to steal the camp, but they at least kept running. Continuing on, 4-0 and a level lead at level 7.
A level lead against Fnatic, 3-10-2, but the spike lane is not something you see too often. Granted, again, there are the adjustments in all the guys that back there to be able to save that business in on carbon site, but it is
I think you're cool, Dredd.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
Because
That was a reference.
Is being here. Is browning their tents. What are we going to see after that? I mean, you'd like to say, well, you can go ahead and get a turn into a number of gems, because it is not something you want to do, wasting those gems.
Yeah.
Because they're also very valuable.
Yeah, a lesser skilled, a less seasoned team would undoubtedly try to use those gems to try to keep their forts alive, but Fnatic doesn't really go that when they fall behind here, and they can tend to do that. Especially because the big toss that happens there too is but because change we have more than two, it's just been tough to do this with Fnatic at the first part of the finals, where they went to the fort anyway before even getting the next turn. They didn't have the chance yet for the next turn, and they're just going to use the chance and make sure they get something out of it, and that something happens to be the first fort of the game.
Yojin and Ridge are up and just getting pressure, but the rest of the group, rather than transitioning forward, making the play happen to be silenced with this advantage, they're just kind of, you know, hanging out in limbo. A little bit too slow, or at least uncharacteristically slow for a team as dominant and as aggressive as KS. By no means is that something that's going to turn around the game, but it's just, when you watch the play, it feels like they play the game 5 minutes faster than your team. And when you play the game, for a moment there, it seems like they were merely human.
Maybe it was that their next objective call was just to get the turn in, because they did have the gems. They were like, we'll just get those
gems
then.
Yeah, we'll go
figure it out. But they got it!
The rest of us will make out. Things are still looking good.
Second turn in phase for KS team. One weapon is out. Let's see what we're doing after the death. We're going to fight them and see if they can help.
Automatically expect top tier Rengar play.
Yeah, because Mexi has amazing timing, things like that. That was Vinny!
Yeah, that's the guy who not only is role swapping, but he's role swapping even part of the fact that he's playing secondary support.
Yeah.
Now he's getting the flank, he's got the total. Bad Vinny here's making the plays!
Jumps in, kills Stuka.
Is nearly full. He's shown that he can in fact be one of us. Blackbits are going to be able to survive there with a reveal over the wall. Look at that poke between the blast and the reset. My goodness, two level talent here. Three forts down, keep front wall nearly non existent across the board as we see Sake looking to make sure that this one is so much longer. And this game has really opened up after those last few couple of fights.
This game is as I expected both teams to go.
To be honest, same with myself. Not taking anything away from Fnatic, but I just figured that there wouldn't be the time or the place that they would go. Just that, again, with the team not making changes, that they would just come out swinging, make everyone look good for at least the first swing.
Well, that's what everybody was saying, right? Like, I walked past their name, like, yes, we win this event. Okay. Right? It's just like that is the expectation, not just of us, based on facts and data, but also just what you've been hearing from the players too, that KS still looks just as strong as they did just a few weeks ago in HGC Final BlizzCon, but Fnatic has dropped blood, and that may be enough to motivate KS. Maybe it will make them question something that they lost the first game of the season. We'll have to see.
Motivation.
Shield,
reset.
Hey, of course it's Vinny.
Vinny goes in and gets the kill, but you know, the members of KSP here, they've got themselves a team, and that might be worth more than what's used to be able to try and zone out the members of Fnatic with the 16 times. Fnatic essentially has to force a fight, or get a turn in 3-6 you've seen from the small window. You force the fight, you're going to try to do it. It's very unlikely you're going to be able to do that. This is very difficult to stop, especially with something like an assassin on one oracle. That's 10 seconds. Nope, not today.
Yeah, and that computer really
brings
the position.
Wow! He hits the flask, he hits the ear, he goes for the throne.